kingdom is everlasting and power infinite. Have mercy upon the whole church, and so rule the heart of thy chosen servant Charles, our king and governor, that he, knowing whose minister he is, may above all things seek thy honour and glory, and that we adore his subjects, duly considering whose authority he hath, may faithfully serve, honour, and humbly obey him, in thee and for thee, according to thy blessed word and ordinance. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth, ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
Silence. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honour, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen.
The epistle is written in the third chapter of Acts, beginning at the 11th verse. All the people ran together to Peter and John, with the portico called Solomon's portico, utterly astonished. When Peter saw it, he addressed the people, "You Israelites, why do you wonder at this, or why do you stare at us, as though our own power or piety we have made you all? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom he handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate. For he had decided to release him, but he rejected the Holy and Righteous One and asked to have him murdered and given to him. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. This we are witnesses, and by faith in his name itself has made the man strong, whom you see and know, and the faith that is through Jesus has given him perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you have acted in ignorance, as did your rulers. In this way God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out, so that the times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord, and that he may send the Messiah appointed for you. This is Jesus, who must remain in heaven until the time of the universal restoration that God announced long ago through his holy prophets. Moses said to the Lord, your God will raise up for you from your own people a prophet like me. You must listen to whatever he tells you. And it will be that everyone does not listen to that prophet will utterly be rooted out from all the people. And all the prophets, as many have spoken, from Samuel and those after him, also predicted these days. You are the descendants of the prophets and of the covenant that God gave to your ancestors, say to Abraham, and in your descendants all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Raised up a servant and sent him first to you to bless you by turning each of you from your wicked ways. Here endeth the epistle.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 24th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, beginning at the 35th verse. The two disciples told the 11 and their companions what had happened on the road, and how Jesus had been made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified, and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? Why do doubts arise in your hearts? my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have. And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." Thanks be to God. I believe in one, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in our Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us then and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of God. heart with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him. Have mercy upon you, pardon, and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. John saith, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be disciples and saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this, as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me." but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. We most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Glory be to God on high,
and in earth peace, goodwill towards men.
We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee.
We give thanks to thee for thy great glory.
O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art the Most High in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, may you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain with you this Easter time and always.
Amen. Amen.